Martial artists of Reddit, have you ever been in a situation where you had to use your skills techniques to defend yourself? How did it play out? An underrated skill learned in all forms of martial arts is how to properly brace yourself and fall. It especially comes in handy when you're drunk. Also, run away. This step comes before all the other ones. Martial arts teaches you exactly how fragile you and everyone else is. If you're in a situation where you have to fight, don't half-ass it. Knock them out and then run away. So, there I am lying on the couch internetting in my big white fluffy dressing gown, like a man does. I hear my GF at the time open the front door and a bit of a ruckus starts. I assume, naturally, that she's fighting another turf war with the neighborhood cats who keep beating her kitties up, so I'll let it go on for maybe a minute. The noise just gets more insistent and there's a bit of yelling going on now. This isn't completely abnormal, but I think whatever and get off my ass to see what's going on. As I walk down the corridor, I can see she's slamming some dude's arm in the door who is yelling on about living in our house. He really doesn't. I say to my GF, just open the door and stand well back. She opens the door and moves back. The guy just starts running in and I punch him right in the sternum, just getting the chance to see his eyes go wide and WTF at the sight of a 6'4" dude in a white fluffy dressing gown. It knocks him out cold on the front step. I check he's not dead and call the cops, who come drag him off. Moral: be calm and don't get your dressing gown dirty. And that was the day I forgot my new roommate was moving in. I got into a bit of a scuffle at a bar one time. Another fellow was being very aggressive towards me and others, including for some reason, saying that he had touched his balls and putting his hands in your face. Anyway, after trying to ignore him, I snapped just a little when he put his hand right on my face and mushed it around. I grabbed his wrist and stepped in to throw him on the ground and punch him a lot, as we do. I caught myself partway through the throw, calmed down a bit and just let him stumble and fall from being put off balance. I was a bit scared I had unnecessarily escalated the situation and was about to have a real fight on my hands, which I wanted to avoid because I am pretty, but he just got up, got his coat and left. TLDR. Guy was jerk. I let my emotions get ahead of me, but it worked out okay. Just tipped the guy over and serious injury was avoided all around. A couple of years ago, my friend told this belligerently drunk guy that I have a black belt in Taekwondo and Gumdo, Korean sword fighting. The guy then started screaming while running at me with his hands up, so I kicked him in the head. First, I'm gonna put a disclaimer here, and not that most traditional martial arts aren't as effect outside their systems as they claim to be. That being said, taking a self-defense course, or some of the more practical martial arts can be advantageous. But that's not what you asked for. So here, I had a roommate who was an all-state wrestler. He was tiny, a lot smaller than me, but he had great technique. I, regrettably, never learned to wrestle in HS. So whenever my roommate was drunk, which was way more often than it should be, he would attack someone, usually me, as we did not get along at all. So it would go like this. He'd take me down. I'd struggle and throw him off. He'd come again. Repeat until he threw up and passed out, or I use the one chokehold I knew at the time to restrain him. It was bad. I knew I only won because of my size. If he was my size and had that technique, I would never win. So I decided to learn some grappling. Did a year of Sambo, focusing on the groundwork. When the commute got too much, after I moved, I started taking Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I can't stress how great this is for anyone, and highly recommend it. It's great exercise, and it makes it so you can get comfortable fighting on the ground, especially off your back. Because trust me, if you are on your back and don't know what you are doing, you will panic. It's a scary position. Learn how to control someone on top of you and you'll be fine. Anyways, I later took a job at a psych hospital. It was a small offshoot of a main hospital, and there was only ever one guard on duty. So 6 days a week, 4 9-hour a day, I'd patrol this place as the only security guard. We had mace, but that was only for life or death situations. Needless to say, a few times I had patients jump me, go for the mace, or try and jump my back, choke me, or take me down to the ground. The first thing I learned in BJJ was how to sweep someone who had mounted me. I can't tell you how many times I've used this in the hospital and in my LP jobs. Learning BJJ and Sambo, even just a little bit, has helped me out immensely. A solid training in ground fighting grappling is the first thing everyone should learn. IMHO. It's pretty easy to take a fight to the ground, and once you do you don't have to worry so much about your opponent getting a lucky shot and fricking your head up. And if you know what you're doing you can take most people out on the ground, because most people don't know how to fight like that. My cousin studied karate for about 10 years. He got into a fight at college thinking he could win because of his training. He lost. Bad. Karate won't teach you anything if you're just practicing choreographed moves. Unfortunately that's all he did and he allowed his training to let him believe he was some sort of ultimate fighter. If you don't do full contact sparring, with pads, of course, it isn't worth much. My high school fitness coach lost his wife this way. She was a black belt in some sort of martial art, and a dude pulled a gun on her, and instead of giving up her cash or attacking him, she went into some kind of martial arts stance to intimidate him. He shot her right between the eyes. Don't be stupid, guys. She might have had a black belt but her instruction was pee poor. I've been training in martial arts for years and I would never tell one of my students to do something like this. Yes, once, I was in a bar and this dude was hella drunk. He kept trying to pick up on my girlfriend. I'm not a jealous type so that didn't bother me. Just laughed at him and said sorry, she's already taken. Well, near the end of the night he comes up behind her, reaches around the front and sticks his hand up her shirt grabbing her tee. I shoved him off and he fell down. His buddy seen this and ran over to help him up, so I grabbed her and ran outside. Gave her the keys and said get in the car. Both guys came out and came at me. It was a huge rush of adrenaline, but broke one of their legs at the kneecap, sideways, to get him out of the fight. After that it stopped. His buddy seen and heard how he was screaming and went to help him out instead, so I took the chance to run to the car. I called it into the local police and told them what happened and asked them to send him an ambulance before his friend fricked up his leg any further lol. Went and filed a police report for it, and had no issues claiming self-defense. They had statements from the bartender, which helped a lot. Repost from me, but yes, once, years ago, was accosted in the early morning by a drunk, homeless looking guy who was looking for the $20 I owed him. I did a nice wrist arm lock and laid him down nicely on the ground. Asked politely if he was going to behave himself now. He said yes, and I let him go. Not screamingly flashy. Face it, you owed him 20 bucks for all that time you spent with Dirty Mike and the boys. Running an F shack ain't cheap, you know. I've trained tap out and BJJ for several years. I also watch a lot of MMA. On more than one occasion I've been forced to use my skills in order to deal with a situation. On one such occasion this punk was acting out at my job. He was screaming and acting belligerent to the point that I felt I would be justified to attack him preemptively. I stepped away from my hot dog stand and subdued him with a Romanian chokehold. He was pretty strong for 10-year-old but I think I handled the situation appropriately. I'm so glad this turned out to be a joke because with each sentence I was liking you less and less. Junior high school. In the locker room after gym class, some guy decides to take my lunch bag. Well, being it was before lunch and I was planning on enjoying the wonderful meal my mom had prepared for me, I grab onto my lunch as quick as I can. This begins a bit of a tug-o-war between me and the lunch-stealing punk. I politely ask him to release my lunch, but he demands on keeping it to himself. So, I switch my grip to my offhand and rain down a series of sword hand strikes to the side of his neck that catches him off guard and disorientates him. He lets go of my lunch and never bothers me again. Victory and lunch in hand. I put on my pants and shirt, and head on off to my next class. TLDR. Karate chopped lunch stealing punk while in my underwear in locker room. This is a riposte from me, but seems to fit this thread. I bought my wife and I heavy nerf weapons. A two-handed battle axe, a pair of daggers, a longsword, a shield. I brought them home one day from work. I cleared the living room and handed her daggers, sword and shield. I told her if thou canst defend thy honor, thy flower shall remain unharmed. But if my attempt is successful, I shall plant seed. We proceeded to battle for about half an hour before I managed to mount her. We are both trained martial artists, which helped make the fight more fair. Sex Samurai. I can get behind this concept in more ways than one. The best thing it taught me was to be aware of my surroundings and trust my gut when something feels amiss. There have been multiple occasions where, when walking with friends, I've just felt something was wrong and asked them to walk on the other side of me, or let's cross the street, etc. Best example was several years back, my roommate and I were walking home from dinner. It wasn't too late, but we lived in a city that goes to bed early, so at 10 p.m, no one was around. From across the street, he was walking south, we were walking north. I noticed a guy who just skeeved me out for some reason. So I moved to walk as a buffer between him and my roommate should anything happen. My roommate never even noticed him until half a block later when he calmly crossed to our side of the street and suddenly took a swipe at me. More like a sideways flail, out of nowhere. Half a block back, when I'd first seen him, I'd felt something like that was going to happen. So I was ready for whatever it was and just leaned back to avoid his hand, as it really was a sloppy hit. As I righted myself, he took another swipe with the other arm, which I again calmly dodged. I stood straight up, looked him dead in the eye, and told him to frick off. He quickly walked away, muttering something. I think he was just trying to scare us. He saw two unassuming college kids and figured he could have a little fun, but thanks to years of martial arts, I trusted my gut when something felt wrong. I couldn't put my finger on it, and 9 times out of 10 when something feels wrong it's fine. But on the few occasions when it's not, I'm always thankful for my sensei sneaking up behind me and giving me crap for not noticing he was there. I've been in around 5-6 fights in the last 4 years, and yes, my martial arts skills have helped tremendously. I'd easily credit the training with saving my life. I hold a second degree in Taekwondo, and taught Krav Maga for about 4 years. Each time I'm in an altercation, it's when I'm trying to talk it down or walk away. I hate how these tough alpha types have to follow you out to your car or whatever to try and prove something. I just want to go home. Man. Crap like this is why I've stopped going out altogether. Can't get in a fight from my computer chair. Though I still go work and hit the gym. Nobody talks to me there. Crap. I'm rambling. As a Redditor, I actually get into a lot of fights from my computer chair. Someone I knew pulled a knife on a friend of mine and held it close to him. I didn't want to hurt him, I knew him, saw him as a friend. So I kicked him off of my friend, and yelled at him to back down. He wouldn't, and kept trying to get closer and get aggressive with me, still armed with the knife. At that point I said to myself, screw this, threw a more Mike Tyson style cross, and made direct contact. He wasn't out cold, I was still holding back. I mean, who wants to hurt a friend? But he had a bad enough concussion that he had to go to a doctor and felt the effects hours or even days after the event at random times. To be honest, I hate that that incident happened, but at the same time, that guy pulled a knife on a friend and violated both of our trusts. In the court of law, he would be the only one armed and aggressive. Knives are dirty. I would 100% try everything to not be involved at all. It's the only way to definitively win a knife fight even if you've been trained. Though, if a guy was on top of a friend with a knife, that's a difficult situation. When I was 10 I was following my parents in downtown Chicago. Suddenly this drunk homeless man grabbed my arm and said, "Hey little girl, can I bring you home?" I quickly twisted his arm and punched the back of his head. He fell to ground screaming. As a black belt, I am proud of this moment. Well, that's rude. He was obviously trying to be a gentleman and accompany you home, unhindered by strangers. I kid. I don't know if this counts, but I was a high school wrestler. In my town it was more of a cult than a sport, so wrestling was something you start young. In my case, I signed up when I was 6. I also took various martial arts classes, kickboxing, jiu-jitsu, ECT. Over the years, nothing I took too serious, just a way to stay in shape and get to spar with pads and stuff. Anyway, fast forward to 1995, the year of the wannabe gangsters. I was a junior in high school and in pretty good physical shape. I was meeting some friends at the mall but got there way early and was killing time by strutting my stuff at the arcade when out of nowhere someone punches me in the back of the head and shoves me to the ground. Here is where my instincts kick in. I see a foot, grab it and pull the guy to the ground. Another guy tries to punch me in the face, but I see it coming and flinch, so he's only able to hit my neck, which hurts but not enough to get me to let go of his body. What happened next I'm not clear on. All I know is somehow my knee ends up in the first guy's face, breaking his nose. The second guy jumps on me and I somehow grab a hold of him and am holding both guys down for a few seconds. One guy is bleeding through his nose, like a fountain of blood, and screaming at me to let him go. The other guy has obviously never been in a fight and is spazzing out trying to get away from me. First guy gets up and runs and I end up breaking second guy's fingers as he tries to get away. 30 seconds after it starts, it's all over and I'm confused, have a headache, and I'm wondering who the frick this guy whose chest I'm sitting on is, who his stupid friend was, and more importantly who is responsible for the blood on my new jeans. The mall cops show up, take my statement, and with the help of a couple witnesses I'm sent on my way and never hear about it again. Trained MMA and boxing for a number of years, never had to use it to defend myself. I've found that just being very confident, but being careful not to escalate conflicts will allow you to avoid the huge majority of fights. Well, it seems that there aren't too many stories of actual situations of using their martial arts in a defense situation, so I have one for you. Here is a little background of me. I have 8+ years of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu training, 3 years of boxing, and 4 years of Marine Corps martial arts. Laugh if you will. My training paid off big time while deployed in Iraq. Now, I wasn't an infantry guy, but I did get engaged into a very heavy firefight. I was with my fire team at the time, which is made up of one point man, one heavy gunner, myself, team leader, and the assistant heavy gunner, guy that feeds the ammo to the heavy gunner. We took fire behind an old shack near the main streets of Fallujah. We had found ourselves in a sticky situation where we were starting to run out of bullets and the enemy had us surrounded. We later discovered there was a total of 18 insurgents firing on our position. We unloaded the last of our rounds and maintained a crouch position behind this locked hut we were near. We attached our bayonets and prayed for the best outcome possible. We still had 4 grenades total, so we figured if a mass group came near us at once, then we should be able to do some damage. The next thing to happen literally would have been a scene in the movies. We were literally attacked one after another. It really didn't make any sense. With the training that I had under my belt, I was able to successfully fend off our attackers and received 6 confirmed kills through hand-to-hand combat. Thankfully for my men and myself, the insurgents don't have proper weapons training to do any real damage, especially up close, and are even worse with hand-to-hand combat. The battle lasted an entire 15 minutes of me basically using the Marine Corps weapons training I learned to effectively disarm my opponents with my rifle and thrust my knife into their critical organs to deliver a killing blow. The jiu-jitsu also helped majorly so that I could effectively throw these men to the ground so that my men and my fire team could finish them off. The fighting finally ended when our snipers came into position and started opening up fire. We weren't certain if the insurgents had all died or if they ran away, because 4 Marines had just taken on over 10 of them without any casualties. So I definitely believe without the proper training, I may be a dead man today. TL. Doctor, years of martial arts prove beneficial in a 4-on-18 death match with a group of Iraqi insurgents in the streets of Fallujah. Saber fighter. Was on my way to a gaming session with the boys on the subway. Guy starts hitting the girl he's with. Rest of the car moves away. I walk up. Tell dude to stop hitting the girl. Dude is like 6'4" and holding a knife. I'm 5'8" and look like a heavy, 220 lbs, goth. Dude ignores the girl. Starts yelling at me about how dare I frick with him and if I wanna go. Slowly starts reaching for my practice saber. Dull as frick and heavy, but it's what I got. I look at how he's moving. He's not a fighter and doesn't know how to use that knife. To him, a knife is something you cut food with, not a tool or weapon. If I drop my bag, I can draw, parry, riposte. Remise advance to his wrist and hit it with a good amount of force. I tell him I have no interest in fighting him, but he cannot keep hitting that girl. He rushes at me. Time moves slowly. I complete my plan of attack and smack his wrist with enough force to make him drop the knife. I then carry the momentum into a hit on the kneecap and bring the bell guard of the blade into his face. Dude had a glass jaw and goes down, but he did manage to shred the sleeve on my leather jacket. I hit the emergency alarm in the car. Cops show up. People, Thankfully, back me saying he attacked me, I didn't draw until I had no choice and only hit him hard enough to knock him down. Girl pressed charges on him, I did not. Girl was very thankful but not my type. She has poor choice in men and was interested in me. This is a bad sign. Had to go to court, but wasn't in any trouble. Took 3 years to get my saber back. I couldn't help but read this in Dwight Schrute's voice. I train in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and Muay Thai, focusing on tournament training, but also self-defense. I started doing karate when I was 3, until I was 12, and started in BJJ and MT at 15. If martial arts has taught me anything, it is to avoid fights. Even though I am very confident in both my stand-up and ground skills, you never know who has a knife, gun, etc. The only confrontation I have been in, the guy tackled me to the ground. I swept him into side control and just held him there until he chilled out. I let him go. No damage done. No police. No hard feelings. If you are about to get into a fight, try to look for a place to run, hide, or talk your way out of it. If worse comes to worse, open hands to the bridge of the nose and solar plexus do wonders. Strike. Run away. I was waiting at a fairly sketch bus stop waiting for a bus that goes to a fairly sketch area where I was hoping to volunteer as a mentor for the children of incarcerated parents. The bus was really late and I had the schedule on a smartphone. I made the mistake of thinking no one was looking and checked the schedule on my phone to make sure I had the right stop. Two very large men, I am a very tiny man, stand on either side of me. One of them starts talking. The other just stands there looking at me and his buddy. I don't really remember what about, but they certainly mentioned my phone. I play it cool for a while, but their intentions are pretty clear. It's hard to convey how I arrived at that conclusion, but I am absolutely convinced they wanted to mug me. Their posturing, flexed, raised shoulders, neck on a swivel, the position they took on either side of me, made it clear. But neither of us do anything really. The bus stop is crowded and there are police not too far away. I did not want to aggravate the situation, so I stood perfectly still, shifting my weight to my heels just in case. The bus comes. They ask me if this is the one I was waiting for. I say yes, I think, and move towards it. They get on the bus ahead of me. I do not get on the bus. I watch as they act confused and end up taking the bus anyway without me. I take another bus and arrive slightly late. I train in Shotokan karate and of course everybody is here talking crap about martial arts styles and about how awesome their fighting ability is and how stupid everybody else's is. Keep your testicles in your pants. I was trained to appraise a situation and pay attention to relevant details, and act with mental clarity upon that. Sorry if it isn't the Hollywood I'm ma beat you up cause you freaking whip me story you wanted. But the practical application of martial artists lies primarily in avoiding the fight in the first place. Guy walks into our party uninvited. A big fatso, about 6 feet 1 inches, 300 pounds. I'm 5 minutes and 11 seconds, 175, and shoulder checks a friend of mine walking past. Before starting a ruckus, my friend comes to me to ask me to watch his back. He was going to ask this guy to leave, but wasn't sure what would happen. I watch him approach the intruder and, sure enough, Mr. Uninvited shoves him, throwing him nearly across the room into a group of other people. I rushed in to try and cool things down and asked him politely to leave. He mouths something to the tune of "frick you be" and shoves me back. "Don't do it," I replied. He shoves me again. "I'm freaking warning you, don't," I repeated futilely. Another shove. And this time he throws a phantom punch to my face, stopping just short of impact in the hope that I would flinch. I didn't. Instead, I made the decision to set this gentleman straight and reaching back to my martial arts training, I struck him squarely in the face with the heel of my palm. Smart. Then quickly after with my fist. Stupid. I could tell he was knocked out immediately after the first hit, as his eyes rolled back in his head. But I had committed to the second strike before throwing the first. And there was no stopping me. I came to find out that, when I punched him, I tore his lip on his tooth like paper all the way up to his nose. He was wearing a red polo with a white undershirt, and he had bled so much that the two were soon the same color. A friend from the party, who sort of knew this butthole, saw him the next day and said he had a massive crescent-shaped stitch lying on his face and a midnight black eye, not to mention a very contrite attitude about the whole affair. I didn't come away unscathed, though. In the process I cut my knuckle on his tooth, requiring 10 days of antibiotics. To this day, I've sworn I'll never punch another human being if I can help it. Some guy was choking his fiancée. Her eyes were starting to go back into her head. He had her against a wall up in the air with one hand. I got him in a chokehold and armbar and pulled him backwards. All of a sudden I feel stuff ripping and he's throwing me over him. Arm out into a forward roll. Back roll and pop up in my stance and he's bull rushing me. As he's close, my 380 pounds friend blindsides him. Seven of us jump on him, and we can't hold him. Several cops come, screaming like a banshee the entire team. If you hadn't guessed, he was high on PCP. My mistake was arrest and control. He ripped ligaments and muscles to throw me. He was huge, really buff and 3 inches taller than me. I should have destroyed his knee or put my thumb through his esophagus, like I was taught. End of fight in one blow. Also, his stupid fiancée refused to press charges. Frick them both. But that was probably the second best fall I took. I was flying laterally over the top of him, and my hold was good. Sort of. I regularly go to this kind of a rough bar in my neighborhood. While I was getting a drink, someone accidentally shoved me, causing me to accidentally knock into some cholo gangbanger who was next to me. He turns around and gives me a two-handed push to the chest, shoving me back a couple of feet. I'm thinking, oh crap, and since I had taken Wing Chun and Shaolin Kung Fu for a year about 10 years prior, I got into this sort of Kung Fu stance ready for the guy to start coming. He kind of hesitated at this point, looking me up and down, and then slowly turned back to his drink. Crisis averted. Fight at party. Pushed into table. Other guy winds up. I throw 3 straight punches, realize how bad it hurts to hit someone in the head without hand wraps and get dumped on the ground. Get punched a couple times, end up triangle choking him but getting badly slammed twice on a cement floor. Friends separate us when he starts making a slobbering kind of a sound. The end. Never again. Definitely didn't have to happen. Hate getting to these threads all late. I've been a martial artist since I was 7. But I am a female and no one likes to fight girls. The most I've ever had to use my skills is at clubs or dances to keep drunkards away from being too close to me. No one has mentioned this yet, but Parkour is more valuable than any fighting style when threatened. I remember once, this douchebag came up to me. I was 13, he would be about 20, and started shoving me over and telling me to give him my wallet. At this point I turned around and bolted over a barbed wire fence into a local rugby ground. By the time he was over the fence I was over the entire oval, so he just gave up. I've studied jiu-jitsu for a few years, the traditional Japanese form which the majority of today's fighters write off because no one involved in MMA does it. Anyway, that's another story. I used to work as a doorman at a few clubs and pubs etc, and yes, I had to use things I've learned to help defend myself. The times I've had to use martial arts to help defend myself, deal with people etc, turned out exactly how my instructor said it would, which I remember him telling me from when I was a young teen. And that is, you just use what you know to make sense of what is essentially a complete mess. What I mean by that is, while I love all martial arts movies etc, you have to accept the difference between fantasy and reality. If someone throws a punch at you, there is no way you can grab it midair and redirect that person to land completely on their ass like they do in movies. Especially not in a dark nightclub with flashing lights, complete with broken glass filled floors and the guy's friends around you with arms flailing in midair fighting with your colleagues. By making sense of a mess I mean having a good great understanding of body mechanics and how we move etc, and how to manipulate those bodies to easily subdue an assailant, to minimize damage received or maximize damage output. I never really had any problems defending myself. Bear in mind a lot of customers are drunk and not trained fighters or anything. Also, I was scared every time. Yes, adrenaline was there during the fight so I didn't feel scared during the fight, but I would always feel scared when a fight was about to happen. I think someone who tells you they aren't is lying, or just stupid. I would like to point out that back then, I was very keen on my functional fitness as well, and I did heavily train my body to be able to perform things at a better capability than average people, and I do believe that also helped greatly combined with martial arts knowledge. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.